Tesla just announced the location of its next semi and 46AD Gigafactories. Actually, from Tesla's announcement, we understand that these seem to be two factories, not just one, because Tesla just officially announced its expected new battery and semi factories in Northern Nevada, along with $3.6 billion in investment to make them happen. However, despite Tesla's clearly using the phrase two new factories, it's still not really clear. Are these actually two new factories or simply the completion of Gigafactory Nevada to its original plan size? And we're going to look at that together now. Earlier today, I reported on the Nevada governor hinting at plans for Tesla's new factory, which were expected to be officially unveiled today. Tesla has now put up a blog post describing its progress with its previous investments in Nevada and the plans for this new investment. I will have the link to Tesla blog in the description of this video, so please check it out with details. But here's what I say. Tesla says that it has already spent $6.2 billion in Nevada and hired 11,000 employees while creating 17,000 local construction jobs, building out its Gigafactory there, and that the factory has produced 7.3 billion battery cells, 37 gigawatt hour plus annually, 1.5 million battery packs, 3.6 million drive units, and 1 million energy modules, which is 14 gigawatt hour plus total. These numbers are higher than Tesla's original 2014 plan, which was to spend $3.5 billion on a factory to produce 35 gigawatt hour of batteries annually, which would then hire 6,500 employees. Since then, the electric vehicle market has expanded rapidly, which means 35 gigawatt hour is still not enough to fulfill global demand for Tesla's electric vehicle. Today, Tesla said, quote, "We will be investing over $3.6 billion more to continue growing Gigafactory in Nevada, adding 3,000 new team members and two new factories, a 100 gigawatt hour 4680 cells factory with capacity to produce enough batteries for 2 million light-duty vehicles annually, as well as our first high-volume semi-factories." Did you notice Tesla said two factories? Tesla's plan to build a new 100 gigawatt-hour 4680 battery cell factory with the capacity to produce enough batteries for 2 million light-duty vehicles annually is a significant step forward for the company and the industry as a whole. The new factory will greatly increase Tesla's production capacity, allowing the company to produce more electric vehicles and meet the growing demand for sustainable transportation. Additionally, the 4680 cells will be more energy dense and cost effective than previous battery cells, which will further drive down the cost of electric vehicles and make them more accessible to consumers. This move also highlights Tesla's commitment to investing in research and development to improve battery technology and reduce the environmental impact of electric vehicles. Overall, Tesla's new factory is a positive development that will help accelerate the transition to a more sustainable transportation system. Friends, Tesla's announcement is kind of unclear about whether these factories will still be on the same property as its current Gigafactory in Nevada, which is still about 60% complete when comparing renders to the current status of the building. Judging by the new render, these new factories may be in the same building compared to the existing building, which has an L shape. And the original new renders of the building filing out that L shape would complete the building. I will have the picture of this building as a thumbnail of this video and also a link to that in the description of this video. This announcement mentions that some of the $3.6 billion will be spent to continue growing the Gigafactory, but also build two new factories. Previously, Electric reported that Tesla was building a production line for the Tesla Semi in a new building near Gigafactory, Nevada. So we're not sure if it's changing plans and will bring all this production under the same roof or continue expanding the new building nearby. The new render shows assembled Tesla semis coming off the line on the left side of the building, which could suggest their assembly will be done under the same roof, or maybe it's just a render. So please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And if you are here first time, please subscribe to this channel, because I'm going to put my finger in the pulse of this story and bring you more as they become available. This announcement comes the day before Tesla's earnings report tomorrow, which is certainly interesting timing. Tesla set a record for deliveries with 405,000 vehicles delivered in quarter four and 1.3 million in 2022, though the quarter four number came in under expectations. Near the end of the quarter, Tesla started offering discounts and has recently drastically cut prices, signaling that it needed to stock demand a little after more than a year of significant price increases while electric vehicle demand skyrocketed. Friends, Tesla Semi is the electric truck that has been grabbing headlines and turning heads since its unveiling in 2017. The Semi is a game changer in the transportation industry, offering a sustainable and cost-effective alternative to diesel trucks. Production of the Tesla Semi began in 2021, with the company ramping up production to meet the high demand for the innovative vehicle. Tesla has stated that it plans to produce 20,000 semi-trucks per year, with the majority of production taking place at its factory in Fremont, California. But now things may change with the announcement of this Gigafactory. One of the major advantages of the Tesla Semi is its range. The truck can travel up to 500 miles on a single charge, making it suitable for long-haul transportations. This range is made possible by the Semi's advanced battery technology, which utilizes Tesla's proven lithium-ion battery cells. The Semi also boasts impressive performance figures, with the ability to accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 20 seconds when fully loaded. This is significant improvement over traditional diesel trucks, which can take up to a minute to reach 60 miles per hour. Here we go, Tesla Semi 20 seconds, traditional diesel trucks taking a minute. In addition to its range and performance, the Tesla Semi also offers a number of safety features. The Semi is equipped with advanced sensors and cameras that provide 360-degree visibility, allowing the driver to see their surroundings at all times. The truck also has automatic emergency braking and lane departure warning, which can help prevent accidents on the road. So lots of good safety features. The Tesla Semi is not only beneficial for the transportation industry, but it also has a positive impact on the environment. Electric trucks produce zero emissions, unlike diesel trucks, which are a major contributor to air pollution. This means that the Tesla Semi has the potential to significantly reduce the carbon footprint of the transportation industry. Friends, overall, the Tesla Semi is a revolutionary vehicle that has the potential to disrupt the transportation industry. And with its advanced technology, impressive range, and environmentally friendly design, the Semi is a game changer that could help pave the way for a sustainable future. And it's very welcome news that Tesla is putting down a lot of money to build these two new Gigafactories or expand the existing Giga Nevada to produce the Tesla Semi. The high demand for the Tesla Semi is a sign of the shift towards electric vehicles in the transportation industry, and it will be interesting to see how other companies respond to this change. With production underway and more companies placing orders for the Tesla Semi, it's clear that this electric truck is here to stay and change the game for good. So what do you think, friends? Let me know your thoughts. Give us thumbs up if you found this report helpful, useful, and interesting. Tomorrow is a big day because Tesla will announce some numbers. Give us thumbs up. God bless you. Tweet it out. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. And I'll see you soon in our next report.